Perfect. Hello, 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 everyone. Good to see you. Welcome. Good morning, good evening, good night, wherever you are. Wow, it's a pleasure to see you. Thank you very much for coming today, for joining us. Wow, thank you. Love you. And it's a pleasure to see here. We have tribe members. I see some familiar faces from all around the world. I was counting about 23 countries, and then I stopped. So I guess we are here in more than 23 countries. So it's amazing. So we have tribe members, and we have completely new participants from the doesn't know points of view. So it's a pleasure. Welcome to the new points of view comers. Just a second. Okay, so first of all, I'm Yaron Golan. For those who are not familiar with Points of View, I'm Yaron Golan, co-founder of Points of View. I'm 45 years old. I'm married to Einat. I'm a father to three amazing boys. My older boy is 6 and a half, and my younger boy is 3 years old. So I'm full power in being a father. I'm coming from a background of psychology and business management, and I'm here in Points of View. I'm the CEO. And Points of View, we are opening hearts, we are breaking patterns, and we are creating a very unique sense of belonging all around the world. We have tools, physical tools, that are based on images and metaphors, powerful tools that can really help you go deeper with yourself, with your client, to bypass the logic and really get clarity and insight in a fun and unintimidating way. So we have our tools, we have physical tools, we have some new online solutions that we are using, very light solutions of our tools. We have workshops, points of view workshops, different kinds of activities online or face-to-face. Some of them are official points of view workshops. Some of them are created by Points of View facilitators all around the world. So we have amazing workshops. Today you are going to get a very small taste of some of the work that we are doing. And we have Academy. We have the Points of View Academy with certifications, programs. We are working with professionals all around the world, like coaches and therapists and psychologists and organizational psychologists. And we are working also with corporates, different kinds of corporates, from Google, American Express, NASA, different kinds of huge organizations and small ones that are using our tools for team leaders, for team development, leadership development, and those kinds of activities. And we are working with individuals, people who are looking to develop themselves, to do some activities at home with their family, with their life partner, with their kids, and so all kinds. So first of all, again, I'm very happy and excited that you joined me today. And we have a very special theme for today. As you can see behind me, the sign Follow Your Dreams. This sign here is here, I think, for the last 9 years. It was even before our previous office. So I'm very connected to this team of following my dream, following your dreams. For me, a life without a dream, it's a very challenging life. And when there is nothing to wake up in the morning, it's very challenging, you know? Every challenge that comes becomes bigger than it seems. It becomes very tiring, very frustrating when there is no strong why in my life, I can tell you. So this is one thing. And also, you know, life are moving very fast. All the time, I can talk about myself many times. I have my regular answers. No, it's not the right timing to do this or to do that. Yeah, I really want to do it. This is my dream for years. But right now, it's not the right timing. I don't have the money. I don't have the degree. My wife cannot do it. All the time, all of us have lots of reasons why it's not possible, why we need to wait, why it's not the right moment, why it cannot happen, and dreams, it's for other people. So I'm very connected to this theme. And I think after the COVID, I think it's relevant theme for all of us. You know, COVID really brought either or both an opportunity to all of our lives, an opportunity to do a change, to follow our hearts, to follow our dreams, to do something different than what we did before. So it's opportunities in one hand and or a necessity. You know, for some of us, it's not an option. It's not a matter if we want to follow our dreams, if we want to change, if we need to do something different. For some of us, it's something that we have no other choice, and life is forcing us to move and to do something different than what we did. So the session today is about following your dreams, following our dreams. And again, a few words about it. You know, some of us, before the COVID-19, we're already set on a path of fulfilling our dreams, and it seems like everything was okay. And suddenly, life happened, shit happened, and all the plans, we need to recalculate what we do. So we need to do some adjustments in our plan, in our big plan. We might need to change it. Maybe even the plan that we had before the corona of our dreams is changed. It's not relevant anymore. Maybe we need to re-choose our dream, recommit to it. You know, it doesn't matter that we were already set on a direction of following our dreams before the COVID. Maybe that after things change, we need to recommit ourselves to continue this journey. Some of us don't have a dream. It's a big word, doesn't mean anything to some of us. It's too complicated. They don't even know what they want, what is their dream. We are sometimes so busy in our regular life, you know, in this mouse race, running from one thing to another, doing this, doing that, with so much pressure, with so much things on our head, at work, at home, so we don't even have the time to raise our head and really to ask ourselves, what is my dream? What do I really want to do? If everything is possible, what will I do? And some of us, by the way, we do have a clear understanding or idea about what is our dream, what we really want to do. It's something so big and so out there, but we are keeping on postponing it every time. We are keeping on saying why it needs to be later, why we are still sitting on the fence. So, you know, there is a reason probably why you came today. Of course, to connect with people from all over the world and to enjoy points of view. But I think maybe, probably there is something more than that for you today. So I'm inviting you to grasp this opportunity today about this session, about this process. I believe it can really bring a huge momentum to my life, to your life. So I'm inviting you, you know, to be like a lioness here today, grasping different kind of insights and really try to make this day today a kind of a tipping point. And the last thing I want to tell you, when we are talking about dreams, and today we are going to talk about dreams, or to talk about dream big, to dream big or to dream doesn't mean that it has to include lots of money and prestige. And it might, but it doesn't mean that this is what it has to be. To dream, it's something that really speaks to you, something that comes from your guts, something that you feel the passion and you feel the drive to go for, that something that you, when you think about it, you say, wow, if I will do this, this is the best for me. So today in our session, I'm inviting you all the time, on one hand, to think, to dream big, and to really allow yourself to fly, and also try to walk out of the traps of really going by the definition of the society. What does it mean to dream big? For other people. Okay, so, and I think the objectives for today, just to be clear, we have three objectives. The first one is to really take a time out. To breathe. For most of you, it's Sunday, so it's a very, you know, it's a weekend time, so it's great. You are coming to me today already in a pose, already relaxed, which is great. I want to take it even further, really, to have a quality time with yourself today, to meet with yourself, to meet with other participants from all around the world here, and to take this time out, to really allow yourself to be. This is the first one. Second one, it's to, you know, in points of view, we like to say that we are knocking on people's door. This is what we do in points of view. We are knocking on people's door, inviting them to bring into their life authenticity, open heart, and different kind of things. So today, another objective, it's for me to knock on your door and to remind you that everything is possible, no matter what is your situation at the moment. Doesn't matter if you have, if you are broke or if you have loads of money. Doesn't matter if you are single or if you have a family. It doesn't matter if you have education, if you have, nothing is matter. Everything is possible. So to remind you that everything is possible, this is one. And two, it's to connect you with your dreams, to allow to you to have a conversation with this part inside of you, of dreaming, and maybe even describe it for yourself in a way that you will know more clear what do you want, what is the thing that you are really aspiring to. And for some of you, maybe for very few of you, might even to commit to fulfill it. There is a chance that for some of you, this is what you will take from today. But again, this is not my intention. And also don't put a pressure on you today. You don't have to decide anything. You don't have to, it doesn't mean nothing. If you're going to allow yourself to fly with your dreams, it doesn't mean anything that tomorrow you need to do this, or if you don't do it, it says something bad about, no. In the next 1 hour and 15 minutes, everything is possible. You don't have to do anything. Just be and open your eyes, mind, and heart to whatever will come. And the last objective for today, it's for some of you who don't know points of view, it's a great opportunity to connect and to learn about our tools and about our method and get familiar with the amazing work that we are doing globally and maybe even to be a part of this amazing tribe. So, you know, in points of view, everything we do, or every workshop, every activity, we start with a pose. Posing, for those who are new to points of view, it means to take a time out with our eyes closed. So in a few minutes, we are going to play beautiful music. You're going to close your eyes. You're going to make sure that you have no disturbance so you can really dive deep and just listen to a music for 5 minutes. But before we will do it, I want to tell you a story. It's a beautiful story. It's one of my favorites, by the way. Some of you who already been into Hello Points workshop probably know it. I'm not sure if you heard it from me, so you have a good opportunity to hear it from me. And for those of you who are not familiar with points of view, enjoy the story. So it's a true story. In the 19th century in Europe, there was something crazy. In the 19th century, there was a circus of fleas, you know, those tiny insects. And it was run by gypsies all around Europe. You used to come to this circus, you will enter the circus, and in the entrance, there will be a huge magnifying glass. You look inside the magnifying glass and you cannot believe your eyes. You see those fleas, those small insects, they are jumping into hoops of fires, carrying tiny carriages on their back, doing crazy things. Yes, those small fleas. And the most amazing thing, that they are not even trying to jump and to run away. Now, I don't know if you know, in nature, the fleas, they have the ability to jump higher than any other human being, any other animal. They have the ability to jump something like 500 the size. So it's crazy. So how do you train a flea? You take the flea and you put it inside a glass jar with the glass ceiling. The flea, in its nature, he loves to jump. This is what a flea does. So once you put it inside the flea, what he's doing? Jumping. And as he jumps, he gets a bump on his head, fall back on the ground. Oh my God, I have a headache. But he's a flea. And he's doing again what he knows how to do again. And he's jumping again. Another bump in his head, falling on the floor. I have a headache, but I'm a flea. So I'm jumping again, a bump. Again and again and again, he's going to get a bump after a bump in his head until the flea is going to understand what. So some of you probably say he's going to learn that he's not, he cannot jump. But this is not the answer. The flea, even though it's a very tiny insect, is still smart. So he doesn't learn he cannot jump anymore. He learned that there is a limit of how high it can jump. And it's programming itself to jump few millimeters less than the ceiling. And from that moment on, you can open the glass jar, take out the flea, and until the moment it will die, it will never be able to jump higher than the height that it just programmed itself. Now, I'll tell you something even worse than this crazy insight, that the flea and 7 or 8 generations afterwards will not be able to jump also higher than the height that this flea programmed himself. Now, I'm going to ask you a provocative answer. Who do you think it's easier to train, a human being or a flea? What do you think? You can just write in the chat. Who it's easier to train, a flea or a human being? A flea, human being, human being, human being, flea. Okay. So it's much, much easier to train a human being. Why? Because a flea, it takes 25 times more or less in average, a bump after a bump after a bump, until this flea learns that that's it, it's too hurtful, I don't want to jump anymore, 25 times. Us human beings, it takes maybe one time that we get a very, very challenging bump in our heads, maybe 2 times, 3 times, we fall in love and then something goes wrong, we get divorced, we get betrayed, and next time we say, why? Too much. Love is not so important. One time we get a bump in his head after we started the business. We share with everyone our vision, our dreams, and then something went wrong and we bankrupt. Next time, I don't want to be independent. I don't want to have a business. Let me work for somebody else. It's easier. For us as a human being, we get a bump that is so hurt that we learn to set goals that are inside our glass jar. Goals that most likely we are going to achieve because we don't want to feel again this pain. So the reason why I'm telling you this story today, I think you already understand, and especially before we are going to go to the pause, it's because if we want or if we don't want, all of us as human beings, we have a ceiling above our head. It comes from our parents, it comes from our experiences, it comes from different reasons, it doesn't even matter. We all have a ceiling and we need to acknowledge it. But when we remember that we have a ceiling and most likely we can achieve much more than we can even think about, we can even dream. And right now, even when I have all the excuses, all the reason why it's not possible, I cannot do it, it will not happen, maybe it's only a ceiling. And if I will get into the right mindset, it can change. So in a minute, we are going to go into a pause. I'm inviting you to be with your eyes closed and just breathe, listen to the music, allow yourself to fly again, no need to commit, no need to make decisions. Just ask yourself, if everything is possible, I can do whatever I want, no cost, no price, what will I do? How will I live? Listen to the music. Every time you find yourself running away or feeling stressed or feeling with the regular answers, take a deep breath. Don't fight it. Take a deep breath and continue the music. So it's going to be 5 minutes and then we are going to start our search, our connection to follow our dreams. Enjoy the music. See you soon.
Imagine every whale was free to roam. Imagine if the trees could tell us where to go. Imagine that the sun could fill each lonely heart. Imagine confrontation never got a start. Imagine things were always crystal clear. Imagine if the mind never interfered. Imagine we could fly with broken wings. Imagine if the heart could shed its skin. Imagine sacred sites were left to be. Imagine if true activists controlled TV. Imagine Captain Watson had the final say. And imagine if industry just had to obey.
Right, so we are going to start. And please get your pen, paper in front of you. And we're going to do an exercise. In the next 6-8 minutes, I'm going to ask you to write down. I will give you the instruction in a minute. And every minute or so, I will ask you an additional question to write about. Okay? The instructions about your writing is that I want you to write, first of all, you don't have to share it, of course, it's yours, and write it in your own language, whatever comfortable for you. And I would like you to write an I statement. So you are writing about yourself. So you don't write something, for example, to live in England, you say, I'm living in England. So it's an I statement, you are writing yourself, and you are writing it in the present moment. You are writing down like it's right now happening, like you are right now in this reality. These are the two instructions. So get your pen and paper. And you know what? I have another instruction. The last one, it's try to be with less filter as possible. Don't let your thoughts, skeptic or what's possible or not, to come. It's okay that they come, but don't let them manage you. Just allow yourself to write down whatever comes, no filter, be authentic. It's for you, you don't have to share. You don't even have to agree later when you read it, but just allow yourself to write it down. So get ready, I'm going to ask you some questions and you're just going to write down an I statement in the present moment, whatever comes to your mind. So we start this process by the assumption that we are starting with. If right now in this world, you have everything that you need. All the resources that you need, all the money, the support, the education, the degrees, you have everything that you need. How will your life look like? Just start to write down. You have everything that you need, all the resources. What does your life look like? I want you to really write it down. Don't stay in the statement level. Really explain yourself in words, in sentences. What does your life look like? Go into details. Describe your feelings, your surrounding. Great, continuing. When everything is possible, you have all the resources that you need, what do you do for a living? What's your job? What kind of work do you do? Who do you work with? And everything is possible. You have everything that you need. With who do you share your life with? Your life partner? Do you have family, kids? Again, just write down whatever comes to your mind. Try to be specific as much as you can. Go deeper. Don't compromise on the regular things that you are always saying.
Ron, in the chat, yes. There is a question. If you can please repeat the main question that needs to guide us as participants. What is
the main question? Is if you have all the resources that you need, all the money in the world, all the support, the education, whatever it is, what will your life look like? I'm continuing with more questions. And again, it doesn't matter. You don't have to remember or to write down every question. Just let those questions resonate in you and write down whatever comes to your mind or whatever you understand. How much money do you earn when everything is possible? And again, to say a lot, it's not enough. Doesn't mean anything, a lot. And the last question, it's not a question, I want you to write in 2-3 sentences, if you can, describe your dream in 2-3 sentences. Try to phrase it in 2-3-4 sentences. What is your dream in this current moment of your life? It might be completely different than what you had in mind yesterday or a month ago or 2 years ago or when you were a child. Today, what is your dream? Your real dream that really comes from your guts, from the inside, that will fulfill you. Might be something about work, relationship, finance, expression, volunteering. Take another minute. You're going to have more time later on to deal with it. Just again, have something written for you to write down, make things more concrete. Okay, so in a few minutes, I'm going to do a demonstration of the process that we are going to later then all of us do together. And I'm going to ask a volunteer in a few minutes to work with me in this demonstration. A few things. First of all, it's an opportunity for you to take the stage as a volunteer to work with me and also to get inputs from other participants and from experience. When we are standing in front of the group, it has a lot of power. And unfortunately, we don't have the space and the time for all of us to do it. So probably you're going to be a very lucky person. So when I'm going to give the chance, you can unmute yourself and take the stage. And again, grasp this opportunity. This is one, not yet, right? It's going to happen soon. You're going.
You're on, we cannot hear you.
Sorry, now okay. I just need you to understand that I might need to challenge you sometimes to be short and to be precise. And you might get also some confronting observations. It might be not so easy, but I think it can be and bring a lot of value. So you just need to be ready for it. And for the other participants, just to be aware about two things. First of all, it's not easy for the person to take the stage in front of everyone. How many participants are we here? We are 218, wow, participants from all around the world. So please, when someone is going to take the stage, let's be empathic and try to be with less judgment as possible and to send this person love and compassion and support, because this can be really a big thing for this person. This is one thing. The second thing is, at one point, I'm going to invite some of you to bring your own observations and inputs for this person. So just to invite you, first of all, to be authentic. Allow yourself to say whatever you want to say. It doesn't matter if your English is not so good. As you can understand, my English is also not so good, and I'm able to express myself. So same for you. Allow yourself to speak, to say, I promise you, we are going to understand. So be authentic. This is the first thing. The second thing, I want to invite you to be intuitive. you might want to say something to this person that doesn't make sense, that comes out of the blue, that you don't know why you are saying it, say it. Sometimes this thing can be the thing that will change this person's perspective. So don't judge yourself or the other person, and don't hold yourself back. Allow yourself really to bring who you really are. So I'm going to ask a volunteer, and I want this volunteer to share with us his dream. And I'm going to ask this person some questions, and then we are going to start and do a process. And later on, all of us will do the same process. So I need a volunteer that have an understanding about the dream he wants, he or she wants to, that thinking about, have in mind, and to share it with us. So whenever you're ready, unmute yourself, let's talk.
I want to be the volunteer.
Yes, who is it?
Vicky from Macau.
Nikki?
Vicky, V-I-C-K-Y.
Vicky, welcome Vicky. Thank you very much. Thank you for being brave and for taking the stage. Well done.
it's my honor. I'm feeling lucky to join the section today. It's 11 Vicky. PM now.
Vicky, can you open your camera, please? So we can
want
all
to see
you.
And we want to put you also on the spotlight, so me and you, so everybody can see you.
Sure.
Oh, that's better.
I'm with my pajama, sorry.
It's okay with your pajama. Again, it's a part of the deal. Opa, great.
Yes.
You look amazing. You look great. Good night, Vicky. Thank you for taking the stage. So Vicky, please share with us what you have in mind, what came to you when you just did this process now, please.
So do I need to share whatever that I just wrote?
No, you can share it.
With the eye salmon?
You don't have to read it. You just share, what I'm asking you to share with us,
my
your
dream.
In your current moment,
okay.
In this timing of your life, what is your dream?
Okay, at this moment, with all the insights I just got just now, the dream is be a motivator and encourage people to chase what they
to be a motivator.
Hi. Can you hear me just now?
You were disconnecting. Can you please repeat it?
To be a motivator. Yes, be a motivator to encourage people to chase whatever that they believe in, just like what I did at the moment.
Okay, first of all, well done. You are walking your talk.
Yes, so I'm chasing my dream as well.
What are you doing today?
What am I doing today? Today I just went out for a nice lunch with my husband.
Okay,
and,
wait. I want to explain myself again. As I said before, I'm going to be sometimes sharp. And in fact, what I meant was, what are you doing for your living today? What is your job today? You say you want to motivate people and encourage them to follow their dreams. What is your job today?
My job today, it's I think attend the workshop tonight. It's something related to that, connected to that.
But what are you doing for your living today? What is your
day? So my occupations. Okay,
yes.
At the moment I'm a self-employed training consultant. So my job mainly is deliver workshops for companies or for communities. And
okay.
One of my main job is to doing Six Breaks certification for different adults from different education areas. For example, like social worker, yeah, teachers.
I have a question. It sounds like in your work today, you are motivating people and that you are helping them to fulfill themselves. Isn't that right?
Yes, yes.
So you are already living the dream. So what is the difference between what you are doing today and what is the dream that you have? Help me to understand it, to take it one step further.
Okay, I think it's different because the job itself is only training people on whatever that they need in terms of like skills and knowledge. Being a motivator to encourage people to do whatever that they believe in, it's another thing. It's not a job. I think it's something really uplift people to believe in their potentials.
Mm-hmm.
I think at the moment, whenever that I meet with people, no matter they're the strangers or my friends or the colleagues that I work with from the last job, like being employed in a big company, a majority of the people they only see themselves like the flea that you mentioned just now, right? They see themselves only like this. But actually, when I'm working with them, I can see that potential is here. But they are always giving themselves a lot of like excuses. So I think being a motivator compared to being a trainer, it's totally okay. Different.
Got it. What is missing for you to be a motivator compared to a trainer? What is missing for you to do it?
What is missing? I think what is missing at the moment is I think I miss a platform or to be able to let more people to know me. And other than a platform, I think I need more experiences to make myself to be more believe in what I believe in as well. Like I'm creating my dream. I'm demonstrating what is it look like if you are believing in whatever that you believe, and then you take actions on doing it, you will become someone else that you would never thought of. So I'm thinking what I'm doing or what I'm lacking at the moment, it's a true experience, like a brand new experience that I have never experienced in the last 30 something years, you know, and I'm going to have an opportunity for doing that soon.
Okay, so you're missing the platform to do it, either as a self-employed or in other company or whatever, the platform and experience.
Yes.
How long have you been dreaming about doing this motivation and to do it? How long it's been in your mind and heart to do it?
I think I will. I only have this with a very clear vision since last year that I resigned from my previous job and become a freelancer. So I think I only have this as my vision for around like maybe 6 months.
Okay, yes. Great. And I don't understand what needs to happen that you will be able to do it even in your current job. Is there a way for you to combine this vision of motivating people in your current job, or it's completely something different?
Sorry, I don't really get it.
My question is, is it completely different job to motivate people, or you can combine it in your existing work today as a trainer?
Well, I think it could be a combined thing. That it's a lucky thing that I think I have. It could be a combined thing. Yes.
Okay. And I have a question, and I have a few more questions, and then we are going to start the process. And from 0 to 10, how much is this dream is burning inside of you in today or in the last 6 months since it came? How much it's really burning from 0 to 10?
From you know how far is it to achieve my dreams? From 0 to 10, I think I'm now in the 3. Yes.
Okay, but it wasn't what I asked. What I'm asking is, how much is this dream about motivating people is a really burning dream inside of you? How much you really want to do it at the moment? How much you are really driven by it?
I think it's always 10, yes.
It's 10.
And it's always 10. And I'm trying to do different things to achieve this. For example, like I published a book this year, and I organized a book club for my friends and my friends' friends, like some people that I don't know. I'm trying to do different things to achieve my dream, to be a motivator or to be a person who can inspire artists. but not at the level that I'm expected. Yeah.
Okay. I have a last question, and then we are going to start the process. In your head, in your mind, what are you telling yourself? When are you going to start and motivate people? When are you going to start and do it? What is your, you know, time frame or things that you are telling to yourself regarding this dream?
Every day.
But when?
Now.
When you are ready to start and go and run for it and make it happen already, or you still want to wait and until you have more experience?
No, I think I'm ready and I'm doing it, yes.
Great, okay. So let's start the process. And I will tell you, first of all, again, thank you for sharing. Thank you for being brave and for bringing it. I'll tell you what we are going to do. First, I'm going to work with you and everybody are going to see the process. And then each one of you will have a chance to do it with yourself. Lior, Marianne, can you please share the screen with us? We are going to use the coaching game. Again, we are going to use a very basic part of the coaching game, only the cards, the coaching game. It's a complete kit. But now we are going to use only the cards. And you're going to choose three cards. Actually, we are going to choose the cards at the moment for you.
All right.
And then again, everybody are going to get a link to do it themselves. And we will share with you also a photo of your cards. You're going to choose three cards. The first card is going to represent. Thinking about, yeah, can you hear me? Yeah. Vicky, having your dream in mind of motivating people and really helping them to follow the dreams and to move forward, having this in mind, you're going to choose three cards. The first card you're going to choose is going to give you an observation about what allows you to move forward with this dream. What will allow you to fulfill this dream? The second card will show you what's holding you back. And the third one, what do you want to invite to your journey in fulfilling this dream? Something that will remind you during the journey of fulfilling your dream. Okay? So we are going to start with the first card. And I'm going to, in a moment, we are going to choose a card for you. What I want you and everybody else, when we are choosing the card, I want you to see what is the first response that comes with the card. What emotion does it bring? And then you will decide if you want to keep this card or if you want to replace this card. So Lior, Marianne, please choose the first card. Okay. Vicky, don't answer yet. You see, this card needs to give you a representation or an observation about what allows you to move forward. And I'm going to guide you and everybody about how to look at the photo. Okay, so look at the card. Try to even avoid the title. Just look at the visual itself. And I want you to look at it from left to right, like it's a piece of art. And I want you to see what comes up to your mind when you're looking at the card. First of all, do you like this photo? You don't have to answer me. And again, everybody else, just be with your mind. See what comes in mind when you're looking at the card. My first question, Vicky, do you like this photo or you don't like this photo? Or more importantly, why? What's in this photo that makes you like it or makes you avoid it?
So I need to answer now?
No, just...
Yeah, I don't have to, right? Yeah, now guiding you to... Okay, yeah, got it.
Okay, now I want you also to know this for yourself. What is the most significant detail for you in this photo? What is the thing that really caught your attention in this photo? And why? What in this detail really speaks to you? One more question, it's how this photo connects to your dream. How this photo connects to your day job now and the thing that you want to do, to your experience, to your platform, to whatever you need. Great. Now I want you also to look at the title. The title is stuck. And I want you to see what happened if you are putting the word unstuck or the word no before this title, No Stuck or Unstuck? Also, what is the opposite of this title for you? What will be your opposite for stuck? And my last question before I give participants to give their own observation about your card, it's how this card, the visual and the title, connects to what allows you to move forward about your dream. Before you say anything, I just want you to sit and to listen to other people's perspectives. Okay, Vicky, are you with me? Vicky?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so I just want you to listen, and what I would like to do, I'm inviting one of the participants that just listened to what Vicky just shared about her dream, and that look at the card and something about this card, about this question, and you want to give a message and your own observation to Vicky. If there is someone from the participants who is willing to give Vicky his observation, and again, be authentic and be intuitive, just unmute yourself and share with Vicky your point of view.
Adriana from Mexico. Hi, Vicky. Hi, Yaron.
Hi.
I very much like this card. And I see that it's stuck and it's and it will be unstuck in exactly the same portion of the nail or the screw. It is stuck because we turn it too much, so it got stuck, right, in the head. And the ironic thing is that it will get unstuck if we just unscrew the same part, the head. So that brings me to the realization that we are stuck from our head. And if we change what we think about whatever we are stuck with, if we just change it in our head, then we will get it unstuck. Our mind,
And what do you think? What do you think? Again, I want you to be specific. I'm challenging you, Diana. Thank you for sharing. What do you think Vicky needs to change or to shift in order for her to move forward from what you just listened?
Sure. Just the way she thinks that she's stuck. Where she needs more experience or a different process or a platform.
Okay. Great. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yes, another person who have maybe a different observation about the title of the visual.
Could I share my opinion? I am Tatiana.
Hi, Tatiana, please.
Hi. I think, Vicky, you are in the right route. Just don't focus that you need more experience or you need to be more rude with you. Just think about the process that I think you are a good trainer. You just need to motivate people like all the days, because everybody motivate people in everywhere, in the bus, in the station, in the market. So you just need to focus that every word that you speak, you motivate the people. So think about just only in the process.
Thank you. Okay, soon you are going to have another chance. Other participants.
I would like to bring my idea. If you guys
share with us, please.
Okay, so really, I have been listening very attentively, Vicky. And I think Vicky is in the right path, okay? She is in the right path because the image so that it is stuck. But like Vicky needs two things, just retrospection and introspection. Retrospection is she has to check the job she left. And she asks herself the question, why did I leave that job?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, when she got the answer to that question, then she said, okay, now I devote my life to that job. then I have to go deeply in that job to mm-hmm. unstuck the stuck path.
Okay, interesting. Thank you.
Thank you.
Vicky, you're going to have the time to share with us also. I'm going to continue. Lior Mayan, please choose Vicky, the second card. What's holding me back? Okay. Again, everyone, look at the card, the second card, what's holding me back? I want you to notice the colors. Some of the cards are colorful, some of them black and white, some of them are monochromatic. What does it mean to you? When you're looking at this card, what association comes to mind? What is the story behind the visual? Sometimes when we are looking at a visual, it arouses our senses. We can hear something, we can smell, we can taste. Look at the photo. What comes with this photo and how this photo connects to Vicky and to what is holding you back? Yes, anyone wants to share? And again, try to bring different kind of observations. Please, if you're just ready, you can.
Yes, yes, I would. Okay. Okay. What I want to tell Vicky is you should open, the photo brings me that you should open your eyes. Perhaps you are already there. Perhaps the thing is just in front of you and you are not seeing that it's happening. So open your eyes.
Thank you. Thank you. Another person wants to give another observation?
Yes, I do. Oh, sorry, my video is not on. One moment, I'm turning my video on. Okay, so there's something that everyone's been hinting out. I don't know if I'm on, but there's something that everyone's been hinting out that I just want to say out loud. It's kind of plain. Vicky, you can't do your job if you don't motivate. You automatically are motivating. And when you were training people at your previous job, the only way that they were capable of listening to you and changing their focus is because you're naturally a motivating force. So you're already doing it. I understand that perhaps you don't feel like you're in the vortex, or perhaps you don't have to show much for it. And that can be a question. At the same time, when you're talking about platform, especially for someone who has to develop social media for themselves, that can sometimes just be an illusion. It's really about just living in the day and actually being able to flow. Because then when you truly are in that motivational flow, it will just permeate everything around you. And then everyone will just automatically know Vicky motivates without having to be told or without having to go to your page. It'll just percolate. Kind of like points of view, right? It doesn't do much advertising. It just percolates too. It pervades, the motivation will pervade through your aura into the space around you. And you already do that.
Okay.
That's how you did your training.
Thank you, Esma. Thank you. You're going to have another chance to say everybody in just a moment. Last card, let's choose the last card for Vicky. What do I invite into my journey? Mm-hmm. Okay. So this time, Vicky, I want you to look at your cards and notice if there is any specific object that comes in some of the photos, not only in one. And if so, what does it mean to you? How does it connect? And Vicky, because I want to move forward and to let other participants do the process as well, what I would like you to do, Vicky, I would like you in a minute, to share with us from listening to the observations, from sharing your story with us, from the cards that you've got, what are you taking with you from this process? So whenever you're ready, Vicky, look at the cards, think about the messages that you got from the participants and what is your takeaway from the process?
Okay, so I can speak now, right?
Yeah.
All right, so thank you very much for all your sharing and insights just now. Some of you, maybe the network, I cannot really hear that clear, but most of the message I got it. I think the insights I got from this process is, I think, I should really being
being present. Like I need to open my eyes, trying to observe what was happening around me. So, and who may need help, like next to me. Like I don't need a very big platform to be a very like famous motivator. As long as I'm motivating people who's around me, I think it is fulfilling my dreams. So sometimes when we are talking about dream big, well, the size of the big doesn't mean like the number of the populations. I think at the end, and motivate the people to become a better self of themselves, that is big. So wow, that's the very good insights that I got.
Okay. Yes. So in a sentence, what is your takeaway? In a sentence.
Believe, okay, continues to be a positive person and motivate people by my own actions.
Amazing, great. First of all, again, thank you, Vicky, for sharing with us. Again, it was only a taste, just to give an example. We couldn't really go deep, but still, I think you got very powerful insights. Everyone, we are going to share with you right now in the link, in the chat, a link to the same process. I'm going to give you like 5-6 minutes to choose your own card, write down your own insights, write down your own observation about the card. Observe the cards as I just guided you. And 5-6 minutes, we are going to continue. So please take the time and allow yourself really to be clear about the dream that it's time for you to focus on in your life. 5 minutes and we are going to continue, please. You can find the link here in the chat. My suggestion is to write down, after you are choosing the cards, write down for yourself on each of the cards, what does it mean to you? How does it connect to your question, to the question of the process, to your dream? Just write down whatever comes to mind.
Yaron?
Yes.
When you say choosing the cards, that's not correct though, is it? Because we don't have a choice. They're all predetermined anyway, aren't they?
Great. It's a great question. Yes, when we are choosing the... We have different two options mainly to choose the cards, facing up or facing down. You are right. Right now, it's not you who is going to choose the card. The card is going to choose you.
I think
I was just checking to make sure, because I think unless I'm something.
But you have an icon of... Exactly. So if you want, you can replace the card as well. My suggestion, even if you got a card that in the beginning doesn't make sense, you don't really like, but stay with it. Sometimes after a few minutes, when you're doing some connections with it, suddenly it makes sense. Good question. Thank you.
Hey, Yaron, thanks for making a cool game.
Thank you, Esme. Thank you for coming every session. I enjoy so much your presence.
Not every session. Soon I have to go back
but,
to...
Many sessions I see you, I like it. But let's keep it silent. I want everybody to be with themselves. So just write down, do the process. And write down, it's important. Just write down, when you look at the card, whatever comes to mind, walk, train yourself in making new connections. And another tip, even hide the title with your finger and look at the photo. The photo is our key, is our door to our imagination, to our intuition. So use the photos to go beyond your logic and see what comes. 2 more minutes, 3 more minutes, and we are going to continue. It doesn't always show the same card. You can just click on the garbage icon and then it will replace the card and you can choose a new one.
I'm just asking a question. Can you hear me? So I would like to know will it be possible for us to write down what we have, like using the photo, because I just hold her like an Android phone, so it won't be possible for me to just screenshot the photo and try to write down what I have. Like,
you have an option in the bottom of the process to save, and you can save it as a PNG, as a JPEG, and then you can save it on your computer or on your cellular, and even use it later for observation.
Okay, no problem. Thanks a lot. I appreciate that.
Thank you. So we don't have too much time, and maybe some of you are already willing to share something about the process. So we have something like 10 minutes before I'm going to start and do a closure. If anybody would like to share with us briefly your dream, again, briefly, 2-3 minutes maximum, your dream, your cards, your insights from the process. If you are ready, just unmute yourself. We would love to hear you. Yes.
Hi, Aaron.
Hello.
Yvonne, lovely to be back again. So very briefly, I stuck with the cards that you had, and I'm going with direction, the screw. I don't always go the same direction. You can reverse as well and go back, and you can redo things that I think I didn't do right. I can get them right and I can move forward. I can change direction. The screw doesn't have to be stuck in one place. With the hands over the face, I am not always in the dark. I am emerging into a light place. I am finding my lightness. I am finding my direction. Mm-hmm. I have still got my hands on my eyes because it's not entirely clear yet. Mm-hmm. And with the leadership, I believe it can be more than one person that can help you or help me get to where I want to go. I need to collaborate, I need to engage, and then I will have my leadership role.
Yvonne, well done for the I statement. Thank you very much. You are the best student. Thank you. Good job. Thank you. Yes, anyone else would like to share about your dream, about your card, whatever you want, briefly focus. Help us really to understand what is your insight from this process.
Hello, Leah here from Panama.
Thank you for having me, Jaron.
Yes, I would like to share my dream. And I've been working 2 weeks ago with a seminar that was conducted here in Panama with Dr. Joe Dispenza. So this is a great complement to what I've already been working in those seminars. So this is not a coincidence. My dream is to find the right partner. I want to find a partner that I feel happy with, that I'm motivated to be with him, that he has all the qualities that I'm looking for in a man, that he's a man of God, he's a prosperous man, and we can share our family together, because I know that at this point of our lives, we already have kids from previous marriages, and our family to convey together in a powerful, beautiful, flowing way, you know, so we can grow much better in this world. And also, because this guy is so prosperous and we live such an abundant life, we create charities, he's already working with charities, and probably I'm already working with charities by the time I encounter this wonderful guy, right?
First of all, thank you. Thank you for really describing us. It's amazing. I have a question. From the 3 cards that you chose, which of the cards really resonates the most for you regarding this dream of finding this life partner?
Okay, wonderful question. The second card I got was freedom. You know, the it was the kid in that merry-go-round. Yeah, on the flying chair. It really resonated with me, the image, right away, because I could connect to my childhood right away. I used to love that ride, and I still do. And
How does it connect to your that you want to find your life partner? How does it connect, this image?
Like, I have to just continue being in the path that I am and feel free to experience new experience, whatever comes my way, like to be open-minded, to be at peace, because this is a struggle that I have lived all my life. I haven't found the right partner in you know, my whole life. So to feel at ease, to feel peace, to feel joyful, to feel, you know, very high vibrating, elevated emotions. I can attract that partner to me.
Amazing. Thank you for sharing, and amen for your wishes.
Thank you. Thank you, your.
Yes, anyone else wants to share with us? Please take the stage.
Maybe I can go. Hello.
Maybe everybody. I can go.
Yes, I will go.
Yala.
I will go.
Please.
Thank you. Hello, everyone.
Hello, Violeta. Good to see you.
Yes, great to see you. Some familiar faces. So my dream is to develop more my YouTube channel. I am already working on, but do not have enough time because of the corporate work. So I would like to dedicate more time for my YouTube channel and develop it more than it is now. So I got the first card that was what allows me to move forward. And I got the card calling. You know this
yes,
the calling card. So the second one, for what is holding me back, I got the card of the luck. Oh my god, yeah, the clear turn, the clear vision.
Mm-hmm.
And what should I invite? I got the innovation card.
And what is the one? What is the one that really resonates with you the most about taking your YouTube channel to the next level?
I think the second one, what is holding me back. And it says, turn to clear vision. I think this is holding me back. I don't have a clear vision how to do it. I don't know how to do it. It's not, and because it is not so clear, I do not go fully into this direction. Mm-hmm. But the third card, with each innovation, maybe it invites me to think out of the box, to change the way I'm thinking about how to proceed.
Thank you, Violeta. Thank you very much for sharing with us.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Yes, last person before I'm going to share with you a few things, and then you're going to have a chance to say
can
something.
I go?
Yes.
Hello, good morning, or wherever you are. I am envisioning sharing my poetry with the world to help women heal so that they can heal their bloodline and create a better world. So what resonated with me was not even the cards that I selected, but the card that Vicky selected, this one. And I need to do this, which is I keep not trusting myself, thinking I'm doing my life and my dream wrong. Although what all of the messages from my ancestors and from anything I'm seeing in my life is to really invite this process. So I want to just thank you for this gift of just, it's beautiful. I feel grateful. And I feel like we are all going to be creating a better world, and we are already doing it.
We are doing it.
I am part of it.
Yes.
And I thank you for letting me do this today.
Thank you very much. And I'm telling you, and also to Vicky, for me, when I look at it, this card, it's also fun. You know, it's a game when you used to be kids, somebody comes from behind, go like this, and you need to guess. So sometimes even the things that seems like holding us back, maybe it's just a game. It's just something fun. Doesn't have to be so heavy.
Yes. Thank you.
Okay, before I'm going to do a closure, everyone, I just want to tell you a few things again about Points of View, about, for those of you who are new to Points of View, today was only 0.0005 of what you can do with Points of View. It was a small taste. We are going to give all of you, new ones and tribe members, 30% discount, 30, for the next 2 days. It's crazy. So for the new ones, I'm inviting you to explore the coaching game. It's a great way to start with us, or if you are ready to jump into the water and to start a journey with us, to check out Hello Points workshop. You will get all the details later in the email. Hello Points, it's an amazing experience, mind-blowing experience, connecting with people from all over the world and really learning how to take our amazing tools and bring it into your country, to your practice, and to bring yourself into it. And for the tribe members that are here, I'm just reminding you that we have Fusion Pro Collection, 11 different new workshops, different activities about workplace, personal, professional, facilitation skills with Efrat Shani, my partner, the co-founder, coaching essentials with May. So check this out. And also we have Turning Point program. I'm going to facilitate in New York in September. Efrat is going to facilitate in Poland in September, Marek in Thailand, so just check it out. And of course, the retreat, we have 6 last spots for our retreat in Peru. You will get all the details later. And for those of you who want to explore with us, we have Shani here, which is our amazing team member, specialist in really helping you to fulfill the dreams. Shani, you want to say something?
Hi, everybody. How are you? Number one, it's really nice to see familiar faces and new faces. I just want to tell you that I'm here to support you. I have small kids, so I don't sleep at night. So I have all the time in the world to talk with anyone that's interested in understanding a little bit more about the workshops, the tools. So I'm going to add my WhatsApp and my calendar, and you can book a meeting. You can WhatsApp me. And really let me help you take the next step into the journey, which I can assure you guys will be unexpected, but precise. So have a great evening, and I'm sending you on the chat, and hopefully we can chat as soon as possible.
Thank you, Shani. And just to tell you all of you, for some of the participants here, and for some other people in Points of View Tribe, the meeting with Shani was the turning point. It started a journey that really brought things that you cannot even imagine. So it doesn't matter if you are going to join Points of View or not, take the advantage, meet with Shani, share with her your dream, your vision, and I promise you, we will help you achieve it. Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter if you are going to join the Points of View workshop or tools, we are with you. So before we are going to say goodbye, I want you to take a moment. You know, we're talking about dreams until now. Again, it can stay something that is not practical or concrete, or we can take it one step forward. But again, I don't want you to push yourself to do what I'm asking right now, only if it comes natural. So take a moment with yourself. I want you to think about one small action that you can do that is only dependent on you, not on anybody else in your life, only you. An action that has a starting point and have an ending point. And I want you to share in the chat one small action that you are going to take in the next week, 2 weeks, 24 hours, maximum 1 month, that will help you to move forward or toward your dream. Again, nothing big, nothing dramatic. You don't even if you just need to sit down and be more clear about your dream, put it in a schedule. So if you are ready, please write down in the chat your takeaway from today, and maybe one commitment to take an action that will bring you closer to your dream. If you want to say it out loud, you're welcome. Just to tell you will get a link later on to our tribe platform where you will be able to share your cards and get observations from people from all around the world. So make sure that you will go to our tribe. If somebody wants to say something as a takeaway, as a commitment, unmute yourself. This is your time. Great, I see people writing in the chat. Great, go to my purpose class at night. share my dream with two persons that will be relevant to make it happen. This is great, Nuria. Again, find everyone small actions that can be like throwing a stone into the water and starting to make small waves that can become life-changing.
And by yes. the way, Yaron, one of them is you.
Okay, great, I'm waiting. Yes, anybody wants to say briefly in a sentence your takeaway from today or your action? You can write it down or you can say it out loud. It will be nice also.
I mean, me. I'm really thanks for the session. It was really good. And so I hope to that I take that next level because I am the first level in years before. And so it's really, really interesting. I feel really good. I have more focus in what I want. And so thank you. thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for saying it out loud for you. Anybody else wants to share out loud, whatever you want, this is an opportunity, please.
Thank you for bringing it in the now. Yara, thank you.
Thank you, my pleasure.
Yara, I'm going to spend the next couple of hours just going through my cards that I picked out. Again, I had that one as well, this one as well. Yeah. I remember.
Great, Christine.
But this one really resonated. I don't know where that came from, but it was definitely a ha-ha moment, and I'm going to spend the next couple of hours while it's fresh just marinating.
Amazing. Great. Thank you, Christine. Thank you for sharing.
Thank you.
Yes, anyone else wants to share before we say goodbye?
Yeah, it's Suki.
Hi, Suki.
Hi. For me, it's, and for the group, it's just keep it simple.
Keep it simple.
Keep it simple.
Suki, I'm crossing my fingers that I'm going to see you in New York. Crossing my fingers. I want to see you again face to face.
I will see you in New York, Yaron.
Yay! Wow, I'm excited. Pleasure. Yes, anybody else wants to say something before we say goodbye?
Yeah, if I can quickly jump in.
Please.
To believe that I can really do it and that I have something to give.
Yes, you are. You can really do it and you have something to give. That's it.
Thanks.
Thank you for giving this statement for yourself.
Thank you.
Yes, anybody else?
Hello, Yaron Alfa from Indonesia.
Hello, hello.
Hello, Alfa from Indonesia. Okay. If you stuck, use another way. That's all.
Okay, I have a question. If I stuck or if you stuck?
If I stuck, use another way.
Yes. If I stuck, I find another way. Exactly. Thank you. Love.
Thank you. Okay.
Yes, another person. Anybody else?
Me, Yaron. Hello.
Yes. I can hear you, please. Anybody? Just unmute yourself
Hello.
And speak.
Hello, Yaron.
Opa,
Kike.
Hi. Good to see you.
Thank you. Yes, same. Thank you for this amazing and workshop. And I take away with me inspiration and continue inspiration the souls of the people. So thank you.
Okay, everyone, I just want to tell you, first of all, it's a pleasure. It's a big privilege to connect with you for people from all around the world. Thank you very much for coming today. Thank you for paying Points of View forward and for the amazing journey that we are doing. And for those who are new to Points of View and also the existing tribe members, I'm inviting you to join. We have some exciting things coming up in the next few months in 2023. I'm inviting you to be a part of it. Let's meet, let's connect. Let's dream together, let's dream big together and make this world a better place. I love you, sending you lots of love from Israel. Have an amazing day, enjoy your night's sleep, wherever you are. Bye everyone, thank you very much. Love you. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, everyone. Good to see you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Blessings to all. Blessings.
Bye.
Thank you. Blessings.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye, everyone. Bye. Thank you very much for coming today.
Shalom.
I miss you all.
Shalom. Shalom. Salamat.
Selamat malam.
Hey, thank you.
Malam, malam.
Malam. I hope to see you guys this year and to give you a big hug in Israel, in USA, in Indonesia, wherever you are. Big hug. Face to face.
Thank you.
Thank you. Love you.
Free hugs from Indonesia. Free hugs.
Yes. Spread goodness all around. Bye, everyone. Thank you very much.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye.